The butterfly effect. The idea that small things can have nonlinear impacts on a complex system. Or in simpler terms, how such a small detail can have such a big impact on the overall picture. There's been plenty of big butterfly effects in the history of our world, but what about the world of Survivor? With Survivor having 40 seasons under its belt, there's bound to be some pretty big what-if scenarios. What if Kelly Wigglesworth beat Richard Hatch in Survivor Borneo? What if Russell Hance was never casted? What if Francesca was a two-time Survivor winner instead of a two-time first boot? Wouldn't that be a world to live in? But instead of pondering over the what-ifs, how about the things that did in fact happen? And how have they affected the long and glorious history that is Survivor? What would Survivor be like if these small things had never happened? What's going on, guys? I'm Flynn Masters, and today we'll be looking at the three biggest butterfly effects in Survivor history, and how these small moments in the game led to such a massive chain of events in the history of Survivor. There's obviously so many different moments that you can look back on in the earlier seasons of Survivor, and its potential butterfly effect on the game. But I think there is one moment in particular in the early days that had the biggest butterfly effect of them all, and that is Brandon voting out Kelly instead of Lex at the Final Nine Tribal Council in Survivor Africa. To refresh your memory, Lex was on the edge after receiving an unknown vote in the previous Tribal Council, which was in fact from T-Bird after she promised Clarence she wouldn't vote for him. However, Lex thought the unknown vote was from Kelly and wanted to take her out next, and he got his Corberon alliance of Tom, Ethan, and Kim all on board to do so. With Lex leading the charge against her, Kelly tried to flip the vote around on him and got the original Semberoon members of T-Bird, Frank, Kim, and Brandon the chance to flip their game around and vote out Lex in a 5-4 vote. And going into the Final Nine Tribal, this is exactly what looked like would happen, as the four original Semberoon knew if they pulled this off, more than likely they would take over the game, as Kelly would no longer want to team with the people who just tried to vote her out. However, due to simply not wanting to vote with Frank, who Brandon had been against all season, he switched his vote to Kelly, sending her to the jury. This left the Corberon alliance together with now the original Samaru against each other, and they were ultimately picked off one by one. So what butterfly effect did this Kelly vote off have in Survivor history? Well, for starters, this led to Ethan Zahn winning the season in a 5-2 vote over Kim Johnson, giving us the first hero-type win in Survivor history. After Richard Hatch won the first season of Survivor, it left a sour taste in people's mouth, seeing the cocky, arrogant man win $1 million. And while Tina was certainly a likable mom-type figure in the Australian Outback, everyone was rooting for the good old Southern boy in Colby to win. And so while people weren't necessarily mad at Tina winning, it certainly wasn't as well received had it been Colby. With Ethan winning Survivor Africa, it proved that the good guy could in fact win Survivor, and to this day he remains one of the most popular players and winners ever. And considering we wouldn't get another hero-type win until Tom Westman 7 seasons later, I don't think it would have done Survivor any good had a player like Brandon or Frank won Survivor Africa. But the most important butterfly effect this Kelly vote off had in Survivor history came in Survivor All-Stars. While Lex was certainly a big character in Survivor Africa, I'm simply not sure what his edit would have been like had he in fact been voted out in Episode 8, as opposed to making it to Finale Night. Had Brandon voted for Lex instead of Kelly, I could easily see Lex not have enough of a resume to warrant a return for All-Stars. However, with Lex being a basic lock for All-Stars after his extended run in Africa, he was indeed brought back, and formed a pregame alliance with Rob, Kathy, and former ally Big Tom. This, of course, culminated in one of the most controversial moments in Survivor history, with Lex saving Amber at the Final 10 Tribal after Rob's bleed. But even after Lex did his friend a favor and saved Amber, Rob immediately turned his back on him in the Final Tribal Council, voting him out, and causing him to become one of the most legendary villains in Survivor history, while simultaneously turning the jury against him, and eventually giving Amber the win. Rob and Amber would then go on to have 4 kids, Rob would go on to win Survivor Redemption Island, and the two of them would both come back for Survivor Winners at War. So with Brandon voting for Kelly over Lex, this gave Survivor's first ever heroic winner, broke previous friendships from Survivor All-Stars, and made both Amber and Rob Survivor winners, producing 4 kids in the process. All of this due to Brandon simply not liking Frank. Guess that movie date didn't work out after all. The next butterfly effect we'll be talking about comes in Season 7, the Pearl Islands, when the Drake tribe just edged out the Morgan tribe in the first immunity challenge. This butterfly effect is pretty simple. Had Drake lost the first immunity challenge, Sandra Diaz Twine would have been voted out first, as this has been confirmed by most of the Drake tribe members in postseason interviews. But with the second chance, Sandra would go on to not only win the Pearl Islands, but come back 13 seasons later and also win Survivor Heroes vs. Villains, making her the first ever two-time winner and the Queen of Survivor. Sure, this is more of an individual butterfly effect as opposed to an overall butterfly effect in Survivor, But I think this just goes to show just how much little things can in fact make a big difference. The fact that the first ever two-time winner was seconds away from being the first boot of the season, in all likelihood would be forgotten by now, is just hard to imagine. But not only was Sandra the first ever two-time winner, her savvy under-the-radar gameplay has become a staple strategy in Survivor. But all of this was almost for naught had Morgan not stumbled at the finish line. The last big butterfly effect we'll be talking about comes from Survivor Micronesia, Fans vs. Favorites, when Parvati Shaw replaced Candace Woodcock, now Candace Cody, on the Favorites tribe. While I don't think Parvati is the biggest what-the-f pick returning in Survivor history, there's no doubt that Candace had a much bigger impact in the Cook Islands, and definitely warranted a return over her. However, due to just starting out medical school at the time of filming, Candace declined a spot back on the Favorites tribe, and was replaced by her former ally in Parvati. Parvati would of course go on to play one of the most ruthless and dominant games in Survivor history, as she created the Black Widow Brigade, was in on multiple blindsides, and ultimately went from not even being part of the cast, to beating the Amanda Kimmel in a 5-3 vote. However, it's not just the fact that Parvati went from not being casted to winning that makes it a butterfly effect. It's the fact that she was part of some of the most iconic moments in Survivor history, and without her, I don't think any of these moments would have happened. As mentioned, her Black Widow Brigade that she created was responsible for some of the most iconic blindsides in Survivor history, such as blindsiding Ozzy and Jason back-to-back with idols in their pocket, and of course famously convincing Eric to give up his individual immunity necklace at the final five, then promptly voting him out. She then came back for a third time in Survivor Heroes vs. Villains, where she was part of the two most iconic tribal councils of that season as well. At the final 15 tribal council for the villains, she was saved by Russell's iconic idol play after Tyson switched his vote from Russell to her, causing him to vote himself out. And then at the final 10, the first merged tribal council, she made arguably the biggest power move of the season in playing her and Russell's idol for Sandra and Jerry respectively, idling JT out of the game and giving villains control the rest of the season. Due to Parvati's influence on both these seasons, Micronesia and Heroes vs. Villains to this day are considered top-tier seasons of Survivor. Both landed in most people's top five. However, had Parvati never been a replacement, none of these great moments would have happened, and I don't think Micronesia or Heroes vs. Villains would be nearly as iconic. There's also other questions that are raised due to Parvati's butterfly effect of replacing Candace. For example, what would Russell Hance's game been like in Heroes vs. Villains had he not had Parvati as an ally? How would have players like Michaela Wingle or Molly Byman done if they didn't have the Parvati 2.0 label on them? While there are definitely more questionable returnings in Survivor history, there's no doubt that Parvati is in the category of a surprising returning player. But with her fortunate return, it led her to winning Survivor Micronesia, being a part of some of the most iconic blindsides and seasons in Survivor history, and her flirtatious persona has become one of the most influential character types in Survivor. It truly just goes to show how a little detail can have such a big impact. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe button if you love Survivor. Follow me on all my social media at Flynn_Masters, and I'll see you next time.